Good morning and welcome to today's maths class, students. So in the previous class we studied about large numbers, correct? We saw Indian system of numerals and international numeral system. So today's class will start with comparing of numbers and ordering of numbers. Okay, so we saw what are numbers in the previous class. So number is nothing but it's a mathematical object used to count, measure and label something. Then we saw place value chart for Indian numeral system. So we studied up to 10 crores. So we have ones, tens, hundreds, then thousands, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores and 10 crores. So we saw example here. So this example we had 12 crores, 45 lakhs, 57,631. Right, then we saw how to insert a comma for Indian numeral system. So first after three digits, that are after hundreds, you put a comma, then after every two digits we put a comma, correct? Then we saw what is international numeral system. So in international numeral system we have ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s. This is similar up till 10,000s. It is similar for Indian numeral system also. But after 10,000, instead of lakhs in international numeral system, we have 100,000. So 1 lakh in Indian numeral system is equal to 100,000 in international numeral system. Then after 100,000, we have million. So 10 lakhs is equal to 1 million. And then 10 million. So 10 million here is equal to 1 crore. And then we have 100 million, which is equal to 10 crores. Okay. So for example, we took this number and we read the number as 14,532,467. So for placing commas in international numeral system, we first place a comma after the ones period, that is after hundreds, then after 100,000, and then after every three digits. Okay, so this is how you place commas in international numeral system. Then we have comparing of numbers. So in order to compare numbers, that is today's topic, what we have to do is we have following rules. The first rule is the number with less digits is less than the number with more digits. Okay, so when we have two numbers given to you, the number with less number of digits is the smaller number and the number with the more number of digits is the greater number. Now next rule, now suppose you have both the numbers have same number of digits, then what you do, you have different steps to follow. So first you compare the digits at the leftmost place in both the numbers, that is if you have 10 lakhs, okay, both the numbers are up to 10 lakhs place, so we'll check the 10 lakhs place first. Okay, so whichever number has the 10 lakhs place as greater, that number will be the greater number. If both of those are also equal, okay, 10 lakhs place is equal in both the numbers, then what you'll do, you'll move on to the second digit from the left. That is, in case it is still up to 10 lakhs, then you'll move on to lakhs. Okay, the second digit from the left is also equal, then you move to the third digit from the left. So just like this, you move on until you reach unequal digit. So even if you reach ones place and they are unequal, then you see which number has ones place as smaller or greater. So which will have a smaller digit in ones place will be the smaller number, and the greater digit in ones place will be a greater number. Okay, but if all the digits in both the numbers are same, it means they are equal. Both the numbers are equal. So some examples. Here the first number has greater number of digits. It has 8 digits and the second number has 7 digits. So the first number is greater than the second number. So which is smaller? Here the second number that is there has less number of digits. So it is smaller than the first number. Okay. So this was what is how to compare two numbers. Now moving on to what is ascending order and descending order. So ordering of numbers, there are two ways to order numbers. One is ascending order, then another is descending order. So ascending order, when we arrange the numbers from the smallest number to the largest number, it is called ascending order. So numbers are said to be in ascending order when they are arranged from the smallest to the largest number. Okay, so climbing up a stair, so moving from a lower level to the higher level is called ascending. Then descending order, numbers are said to be in descending order when they are arranged from the largest number to the smallest number. So when I arrange numbers from the largest number to the smallest number, it is called as descending order. So numbers are said to be in descending order when they are arranged from the largest number to the smallest number. Okay, so climbing down the stairs, that I when I move from the higher level to a lower level, it is called descending order. So some examples. So here four numbers, you have to arrange them in ascending order. So the smallest number here is this, that is 9,84,671. Then as the number of digit increases, the numbers also increase. So this is from smallest to largest. Then arrange the following in descending order. Here the number with greatest number of digits and the biggest number you write first, then the second biggest number and so on till you get the last. That's the smallest number. Okay, so this is how you arrange numbers. Now we'll see a few problems on ascending and descending order and comparison of numbers. Okay. So here comparing numbers, as I told you the rules for comparing numbers. Okay. Then ascending order, descending order. So exercise 1.2. Now here for exercise 1.2, what you have to do? First, fill in the blanks with correct symbol, that is greater than or less than. So this is the greater than symbol and this is the less than symbol. Okay, so first one. First question A1, 87,85,315. 78,53,150. So we'll check, both have same number of digits. So we'll check the 10 lakhs place. So 10 lakhs place in first number is 8 and the second number is 7. So 8 is greater. So the first number is greater than the second number. Now, next we have 4,67,25,892. Here we have 4,67,052,000. 4,67,52,892. So here crores, 10 lakhs, lakhs all have the same digits in both the numbers. So moving on to 10,000. 10,000 in first number has 2 and second number has 5. So 2 is smaller than 5. So we'll put this sign. Okay. Then 63,15,085. 36,51,850. Now again we have same number of digits. The first digit, that is 10 lakhs place in the first number is 6 and the second number is 3. So 6 is greater than 3. So we'll put this sign. Okay, now question D. 15 crores 30 lakhs 65,752. 30 lakhs 15 thousand, sorry, 30 crores 15 lakhs 56,257. So the first one, 15 crores is obviously less than 13 crores. So first number is smaller than the second number. Okay, then write in ascending order. So the given numbers you have to arrange in ascending order. Okay, so which is the smallest number here? It is 34,758. Then after that we have the next smallest number, 54,738. Then now 1,54,000, 1,74,000. So 1,54,000 is smaller. So 738. And then we have, I'll write on the next line, 1,74,538. Okay, so this is how you arrange the numbers in ascending order from smallest to biggest. Okay, so this was question one. Now question number B, here which is the smallest number here? We have 9,85,376 as the smallest. Then after that we have 26,92,375, then 29,62,350. 6. Okay, and then the last number is 89,53,750. So this is how you arrange the numbers from smallest number to the greatest number. Okay, now C question is at home, so do that for homework. Okay, then moving on to this question number 3, that is write in descending order. So descending order means largest number to the smallest number. Okay, so here the largest number is 2,75,843. Then we have 98,721, then 35,419, and last 6,858. Okay, then here, which is the greatest number? Here it is 7,65,017. Then we have 6,75,107. Okay, then we have 5,76,017. Then we have 5,67,070. Okay, so this is how you arrange numbers in descending order. Then at home, so question C, 3C, okay, you have to do it for homework. Now using the digits 2, 4, 5, 4, 7, 1 and 0, form the largest 6 digit number. Okay, I'll write it here. So to form the largest 6 digit number, what you do, first you write the greatest digit, that is 7. And after 7, I have 5. Then after 5, I have 4. Then 2, 1, 0. So this is the greatest 6 digit number. And question B, the largest 6 digit odd number. Okay, so that will be 7, 5, 4, 4, 2. So instead of putting 1, 0, I'll put 0, 1. Okay, since it's ending in 1, it means it's an odd number. Then the smallest 6 digit number. For smallest 6 digit number, I'll just put 1, 0, 2, 4, 5, 7. Okay, then the smallest 6 digit even number. So to find the smallest 6 digit even number, I'll put 1, 0, 2, 5, 7, 4. Okay, so this is the smallest 6 digit even number. So any number ending with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0 is called a even number. Any number ending with 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 is called an odd number. Since this number is ending with 4, this is an even number. So this is how you compare numbers and arrange numbers in ascending and descending order. Okay, so next class we will see how to round off numbers and what are the Roman numbers. Alright, students, I'll see you all in the next class. Thank you.